This video is brought to you by Ageless Geeks.
Cowabunga dudes and dudettes, this is Anthony, aka BatBomb82, and today I'll be doing a review of the Power Rangers Lightning Collection Magna Defender. Now, taking a look at the front, we can see that the figures showcase in your standard Lightning Collection window box packaging. Turning the box around, we can see a really cool image of the Magna Defender. So with the box out of the way, let's crack this figure open and see what we have inside. And here is the Magna Defender out of the box. And oh man, this is a really good piece from Hasbro. They have been killing it, like I've said, with the Power Rangers Lightning Collection. And the Magna Defender getting in here so soon is really freaking cool. There is a ton of good stuff going on with this guy that I cannot wait to check him out with you guys. But before we take a closer look at the figure, let's take a closer look at his accessories. So the Magna Defender does come with a good amount of accessories. Starting off, we get his sword with a sheath, his rifle, four interchangeable hands, and a blast effect piece. So with the accessories out of the way, let's take a closer look at the Magna Defender. Alright guys, now let's take a closer look at the Magna Defender. And man, I am so shocked that we got this guy so soon in the line. And he's incredibly well done. I love this. Now, I've actually been going back and watching Lost Galaxy episodes lately. And it's pretty messed up how this guy's introduced on the show. His son was basically killed by the main villains of the series. And now he is out for revenge on that villain, and he's kind of brutal about it. Like, he doesn't care about the safety of, like, innocents around him. He's just thriving on taking out the main villain, and it's a pretty dark story. It's very interesting, and unlike a lot of stuff that we see in Power Rangers, and that makes the Magna Defender very unique and very different from a lot of other characters on the show. And one thing that was really weird is that his son looked just like him, just a tiny little kid version of Magna Defender with a helmet and stuff like that and armor. It was pretty funny, but still the story itself is pretty dark and makes this character, again, so much more interesting. Now, everything about this figure looks really good. I love the helmet. Just looks so nice with the gold and the silver and the black and that nice metallic green. All that looks really good. You even got his, like, bull horns, which is kind of his thing, especially with his Zord, having the Toro Zord and things like that, the bull Zord. And all of this looks really nice. Again, that nice metallic silver. I kind of wish this was a little more, like, glittery, because that's kind of how it is in the show. It more sparkles and whatnot. But that's still really, really nice. They got the little zigzag pattern that we see with all the Lost Galaxy characters. And for the most part, this guy's pretty much just the Lost Galaxy Black Ranger. That's initially what he is. But all this looks really good. I love how you see the texture on his suit and his armor like that. It looks really cool. I love the fact that they're doing this with all the Ranger figures. It's not just smooth surfaces. You really do see a difference in texture in certain areas, and I love that. It really makes these figures stand out and makes them feel a little more special. Again, unlike what Bandai America was doing with their lines, those toys were just garbage, to be honest with you. But the boots look really good. Peg holes on the feet look really nice. Everything about this got some silver on the gloves. This all looks really, really good. The cape is a more softer rubbery plastic. That looks really nice too. The sculpted folds on there all look really nice. Got the red inlining on there. Got his back right here. Some Magna Defender booty back there. All looks really nice. Everything about this guy looks awesome. This is a beautiful figure, and I'm super stoked to add him to the collection. Alright, now let's talk about his accessories here. So I do have interchangeable hands. We do get a trigger finger hand for his right side, and a more loose, semi-gripping hand for his left side. We also do get a fully loose hand for his right side, like so, and then a gripping hand, more standard gripping hand, for his left side. Those are for holding his different weapons. Now we do get his sword right here, which is really cool. I love the way this turned out. just the whole black and everything like that looks nice. You can actually pull this out of the sheath like so, and then we have a closer look at the sword, which just looks really good. Again, I love the fact that they're actually adding a good amount of paint detail to a majority of the weapons for the Rangers. They could have just simply done this in like all black, you know, and maybe just a silver blade and just left it at that, and probably would have been, you know, expected. But they're going in more detail, and I appreciate it. It feels like they're really showing the care for Ranger toys that we should have gotten a long time ago. So that holster's in there like that. And you can see it does have a little peg right on there, because on his belt right here, we do get a little peg hole. And you can just peg that right into there, and it holds onto there very nicely. And then you can use him to draw his sword, and he holds it in either of the gripping hands. What's also really cool is if you don't know the show, this whole thing right here turns into his gun, and you can kind of see where it's like a barrel like that, and you can see the cocking device for like a shotgun kind of wood. That's because this turns into this again, which is really cool. I love this. So here it is in gun form, basically. Again, with more paint detail. This one even has a gold line going across the top like that, which the sword version doesn't. You can see that. So the shotgun version actually has more gold like that, and this is just fantastic. You cannot remove this one. This is all one solid piece. Again, looks really, really cool. And you can get that in his trigger finger hand like so. It's a little tight like that to get that in there. And then you get that more like semi loose gripping hand, and you can hold it onto his barrel like that, like he's holding it like so. And you get some nice two-handed poses. Again, I think this came out really good. Loving all of that. But what we also get is an effect piece for his rifle. Now again, this is one thing I've been cheering and praising Hasbro for, is that they're giving us effect pieces with like every figure. And that is so appreciated. And this is why I'm going to be all in on this entire line. So it actually is kind of formed to the actual rifle itself. So you got to kind of find the right way to fit it on there. Let me see, like this maybe? There it is. Just like so. And you get it on there and it looks awesome. So the accessories he does come with are pretty perfect for the character. Alright, so now let's run down his articulation. So it hits on a ball joint, doesn't roll around a bit, mostly going to get left and right. You're only going to get looking up about that much, because the lip of the back of the helmet hits the cape right there, so you're not going to get a whole ton of motion. You can look down a little bit, but this thing has a whole collar around there, so even with that disc hinge, you don't get a ton of up and down motion, so mostly left and right. What's cool is that these shoulder pads are on a hinge on both sides, so when you can move those out the way, and you get the arms all the way up, and there's a really tight joint right there, so just be careful. You don't want to break it, but it is very, very tight on mine, so it goes up that far. We get a butterfly joint in there, which is really nice. Rotation at the bicep, we got double jointed elbows, rotation at the wrist, as well as a hinge at the wrist. We get a ball peg in the midsection right there, so that rolls around, turns left and right, crunches back and forth, and pivots side to side. And then we get an actual ab crunch right in there, so it crunches all the way forward that far and all the way back that much. That's really cool. I love the design they're doing with these Ranger figures. We got hip joints that kick forward that far, back about that far, which is pretty good. Splits about that much. Hindered a little bit because of the thigh guards right there. It does hit the waist, so it's not terrible, but it could be better, I guess. But I totally understand. Rotation in the upper thigh. We got double jointed knees. We can kick himself in his own butt, so that's really good. We got no boot rotation. We got an ankle joint that goes up and down, just like so. Rotation at the ankle, and then a very, very good ankle rocker. So overall, I think this guy is amazing. This is something that a lot of us have been wanting for a long time, because the Magna Defender is such a cool and unique character in the whole mythos of Power Rangers, and he's deserved a very cool figure forever, and Hasbro is the one to finally give it to us. So for a quick size comparison, here he is standing next to a Marvel Legends Deadpool figure, as well as a DCUC Batman figure. And for your Ranger comparison, here he is standing next to the Lightning Collection Lost Galaxy Red Ranger and Beast Morphers Gold Ranger. And just for fun, here he is standing next to Little Lego Bat Bomb. So there it is, guys, my review of the Power Rangers Lightning Collection Magna Defender. Now, overall, I think Hasbro has done a great job with this, and I'm super stoked that we're getting the Magna Defender in this line. That's still very cool to me. For so long, we have waited for a good figure of this fella, and we finally got it, and it's all thanks to Hasbro. I think they did a great job with the sculpt, the paint, I love the articulation, and I really dig those rad accessories. This is one piece that if you're a Lost Galaxy fan or a Power Rangers fan, you will absolutely love this action figure. So please comment, like, and subscribe. Stay nerdy, my friends. Peace.